Simon. Have you found the first 4 days here?
Yeah, it's been great. Obviously, the jet lag's slowly wearing away now, but certainly coming here on Friday and going to Salford was a really good experience, and for the boys to dig in the way they did and get the result, it was a nice end to a long day, put it that way. But no, everything's been good so far. So far, so good, and I'm really enjoying it.
You've been watching the team from afar for a few weeks now. Did you learn more about them, having seen them in the flash last week?
Oh yeah, I've been learning all the time now. Everything's new to me, and I've come in here with an open mind. And obviously, we've got to review quite a bit of stuff leading into last week. But there's nothing like being here and out in the training paddock and watching the game live. There's nothing like doing that. So I think it's going to be about learning about the players and the players learning about me. That will be ongoing for the rest of the year and beyond.
Something clearly has changed when you look at the performance and the results. What do you think you've been able to change, either from afar or when you've got here?
Look, I think, I sat down with Chris and Robbo and Mark Andrews a few weeks ago, and we discussed what we needed to do, what we needed to improve and what we wanted to introduce. And I think those guys have done a really good job introducing those things over the past 3 or 4 weeks. And the most important thing is that the players have bought into it. They believe in what we're trying to do, and they've worked hard to make sure they've been able to execute. And the things we're introducing, it really makes them accountable, individuals accountable for their role in the team, both defensively and with the ball. So they've taken that on board really well, and they're all trying really hard, and they're getting better every week. So I think you'll see just improvement after improvement with the team and with the squad from here till the end of the year.
How much more do you think there is to come from this squad?
Oh, there's plenty. Like, we got a pretty good squad. Obviously, it helps some guys coming back from injury over the past few weeks, but we've got a really good squad, I believe. That's a good enough squad to win a lot more games between now and the end of the year. It's just about, like I said, they're bought in to what we're trying to achieve, and they're working hard, and they're coming in individually and reviewing their game and reviewing their training. So, when I'm seeing that sort of attitude from the players, we're going to get improvement.
What about possible new faces? Are you down the line on anything?
We've obviously discussed, where we need to improve in the squad, and there's some guys here on contract, so we need to see where they're at. We're always looking for new players to come into the squad, both from England and overseas. So we'll talk more about that in the next few weeks. Obviously, I've just got in with, had a game on Friday. We've got a pretty important game tomorrow night. So that sort of stuff's at the back of the mind at the moment, but it's certainly something we'll spend a bit of time on in the next couple of weeks.
Before you came, did you have players back home saying, giving you a ring? Maybe people you haven't heard from for a while.
Yeah, I was getting 3 or 4 phone calls a day saying, don't forget me. So, but no, look, it's always good. There's always guys over there keen to come over, and it's a great part of the world, and being so close to everything over here, particularly guys, the back end of their career that think they might be finished in the NRL, they're always looking to come over for a year or two. But we're looking to get players over that still got plenty to offer. We don't want, players coming over here just because they think they can get another year or two out of their career. We want players coming over there who've still got some good footy left in them. And, we'll be pretty selective in what sort of players we target. So, again, we've had brief conversations about that with Richard and the other coaches. We'll get a little bit more serious about that over the next couple of weeks.
Will you take full charge for this week onwards?
Yeah. Obviously, Chris has done a fantastic job, and we'll work together. We'll continue to work together. Robbo's here. He's obviously got the academy team as well, so he's doing a fair bit with us as well. But it will be a team. We'll work together as a team. We'll have roles during the week, and we'll have roles game day. And the good thing, we've got very similar views to our footy, myself and Chris and Robbo, so we've worked really well together so far, and I don't see why that won't continue.
What do you know about the Challenge Cup? What do you know about Catalan Dragons?
Yeah, look, we've done a fair bit of work on the Catalan Dragons already. They're in a similar position to us. They've started the year poorly, and they've been able to string a couple of wins together of late, so they're on the improve. Drinkwater's there now. He's doing okay. Kenny Edwards, we think, might play tomorrow night, so he's going to add a bit there. But while we've had a bit of a look at them, and we've talked about some things where we need to be good, and we need to counteract with those guys, we've spent more time on ourselves and making sure, like I said, we're improving, reviewing our game, reviewing our training, making sure we're fixing up errors, both with the ball and when we're defending. We're working hard to eradicate those sort of errors in our game. So while we've had a bit of focus on the Catalans, we've it's been a lot of focus on what we're doing.
Could this be the week for your captain, Leroy Cudjoe?
Well, so far so good. He's got through sessions this week. He's named to play, so we're expecting Leroy to play. You know, we're not going to expect the world from him. He's had a long injury layoff, so we just want Leroy to come back and get some game time, and we'd expect him, naturally he'll improve from week to week, so you know, won't be relying on Leroy tomorrow night. We just want him to get out and get a feel for the game again, have a run, and you know, more importantly, just get through the game and feeling good and get some confidence out of that so he can go again next week.
Your first game in charge will be a home game as well. Quite a nice occasion for you.
Yeah, it is, and like I said, it's a Challenge Cup, so I've know quite a few people who've played over here and coached over here, and I know exactly how important the Challenge Cup is, so it's nice to get a game at home and a quarter final and a semi final spot up for grabs. So look, we've got a lot of reasons to play well tomorrow night. You know, we've trained pretty well, we've prepared pretty well, so I'd expect the guys put in a pretty good performance tomorrow night.
You'll have seen the stadium over there, you'll see the facilities here as well. How does it compare with what you've seen back home?
Oh well, the stadium's as good as any. It's a great stadium. I mean, I've seen it a few times on TV and I thought it's a pretty nice looking stadium, and yeah, it is, it's a really good stadium, it's up there with any, and the facilities here, we've got everything we need here, so you know, there are no excuses. We feel we've got everything we need, we've got the squad to be able to, you know, perform well over the next couple of months, so we just need to keep at it the way we are, and I think you'll see some pretty good footy out of this team from now to the end of the year.
Talking of which, what is the aim for you? What's the dream? Is it top eight survival, or dare you look a bit higher than that?
Well, first and foremost, obviously, we want to be in that top eight. We don't want to have to go and play in the Super Eights at the end of that. So if we can stay where we are at the moment, climb up a little bit, and then have seven games left after the split in the competition, well, anything's possible. But first and foremost, we just need to get our own backyard in order, make sure we're preparing well, playing well. And like I said, I'm pretty confident if we do that, we can get the wins along the way.
Tom, thank you, Simon.
Cool, Matai, what's the deal with him injury-wise?
Yeah, he's done quite a severe medial ligament, so he'll be best case scenario for Akuma 6 weeks. So it's a bit of a bummer. We're getting players back, and Akuma was doing a really good job for us. So unfortunately, it's a part of the game. He's going to be missing for a little bit of time. But you know, we've got obviously Leroy back this week, Murphy back this week, Ferguson not too far away, so we've got a little bit of depth in the forwards at the moment to be able to cover Akuma. It's disappointing he's missing, but I'm sure he'll do everything right and get back as quick as possible.
And one of the changes is seeing Jake Mallow going to centre, Jordan Rankin fullback, Jordan Turner to six. Seems to be working. Is that obviously that's something that you wanted to see that change around?
Yeah, look, once I got the job, I had a look at how we wanted to play and who would be best suited in the positions the way we wanted to play, and that's what I thought would work best, and it's important in any team you keep that spine together and let them play some footy together. They'll naturally improve every week. I think they've done a pretty good job at the moment, and you know, there's no reason to change that at the moment, and we'll just stick with that for the short term.
And what did Nathan Brown say to you about Huddersfield then when you spoke to him about the job?
Well, good. He loved Huddersfield, he loved his time here, he loved the club, he loved, you know, Huddersfield as a place to live, so he was obviously all positive about the move, and asked me if I'd be interested in doing the job, and obviously gave me a good reference to Richard and Ken. So he was happy for me, and really had only positive to say about Huddersfield, the town, and Huddersfield, the rugby league club.
And obviously you're at that age now with that experience where you feel ready to really take over and then coach's job.
Yeah, I think the last couple of years at the Knights, you know, I learned quite a lot about the defensive side of the game. I mean, you know, breaking it down and the little intricacies in being a good defensive team. So I think getting that knowledge under my belt and that experience over the last 18 months made me feel like I was ready to tackle a head coaching job overseas. And as it turned out, an opportunity came up. And I must admit, if you had told me at the start of the year I'd be over at Huddersfield coaching mid-year, I would have said you're bloody mad. But it just turned out that way, and you know, the job came up, and took the interview, and luckily enough the hierarchy showed some faith in me, and here I am.
And just on Catalans, obviously a lot of ex-NRL players in there, like Greg Bird and players like that. You'll know plenty about their squad, won't you?
Yeah, look, Bird's still got plenty to offer, and Kenny Edwards, if he plays tomorrow night, he's going to be a handful. You know, blokes like Mead's still, I think, at the top of his game. He's quite dangerous, so You know, they got some other, you know, the fullback there for the Catalans is a good player too, and they got Casty and Sam Moore. So they got quite a strong squad. I'm surprised they haven't been better the front half of the year, but yeah, they're going to be tough. We need to start well. We need to start a lot better than we did last week against Salford. So that'll be a real focus for us tomorrow night. And we feel if we start well and we play like we've trained and improve on what we've done over the past month, we feel we can get the result.
Chris said that he actually showed you a training session over Skype. So how did that work, and what did you manage to spot anything, or did your Wi-Fi give up?
Yeah, no. Like for what we had, we managed it quite well. It was quite clear footage of the Skype stuff that we were looking at. Sometimes they'd just send me a video file and I'd go over it, and then we'd talk the next morning. It was a bit tricky with the time differences, but sometimes we watched it together over Skype and we talked about it along the way. But I thought we got a lot out of it, like particularly considering I was a couple of weeks later than I would have hoped. I'm glad we got started when we did, because you know we gained a lot out of those couple of weeks.
So there's like three or four sort of different sort of videos that you saw of Huddersfield, both in game and in training, that you could pick up on, was it?
Yeah, I watched a couple of games and watched at least one training session a week. And you know, we talk about before our game, we talk about how we wanted to play, and we talk about after the game about where we can improve and what we need to do better and where we were good. So like I said, for what we had, we made it work pretty good.
And now you're actually here. Have you spotted anything else that you perhaps didn't spot in the videos?
Oh yeah, look, there's heaps to improve. Like there's a lot of work to be done. A lot of areas we can improve individually and as a team, and you know, that's just going to evolve over time. You can't get everything done in 1 week or 2 weeks. You've got to sort of prioritise what we need to fix now and what we can work on over the next few weeks. And we've done that. You know, we've done it quite a bit this week defensively and where we need to improve. So, like I said, I expect that each game now you'll see gradual improvement from the squad.
It's the main sort of area of improvement defensively, is it?
Well, yeah, defence is the hard part of the game. You know, it's you know, mentally and physically it's tough, and under fatigue making decisions and making sure you do your job's very difficult. So you know, we can practice that under fatigue. We can talk about it all we like, but we need to practice it under fatigue, and again, when we get some more time and we get some longer turnarounds, we'll be able to do more of that. But at the moment it's you know, 5 day turnaround, 6 day turnaround, you can't get a lot done, but there'll be opportunities down the track.
What is the Simon Wolford type of team, Simon? What are you working towards? What
do
you want from your team
ultimately? Oh, look, I want a team that works hard for one another. Not work hard for me, I want them to work hard for one another. And, you know, have that siege mentality where we never give up. You know, when we do defend, we've got to love defending. You know, we can't shirk it, the defensive side of the game. We've got to make sure when we're defending, we love defending and we want to do it. We want to work hard for each other. I mean, you know, when you do that, that's when you earn the right to get the ball in place in front of you. So it's going to be a big focus defensively, from my point of view. As far as our attack, obviously I want to play some footy, but again, we need to learn to earn the right when we can play footy and when we can't. So, but yeah, I want 17 guys who want to play for the club and want to play for each other and want to work hard for each other. If we can get that, like I said before, there'll be plenty of games that we win along the way.